Let's start with Gus.
Yep. So we're going to talk today about some features of the Google Plus mobile platform. And these are really kind of timely right now because just last week, I believe, there was the release of the Google Play services. And this kind of lit up these platform features for Google Plus within Android. And so the three features we're going to kind of highlight today are the Plus One and the Share and then sign in with Google Plus. So Chirag, want to tell a little bit more on how this gets incorporated?
Yep. Thank you, Gus. So the Google Plus Android SDK actually lives inside Google Play Services. Google Play Services is a platform that lives right next to Google Play. This means that it is deployed to all Android devices that are Froyo and up and that contain Google Play on it.
Chirag, when you say is deployed, do you mean it's already been deployed or it will be?
It has already been deployed.
And so users don't have to do anything to update it themselves. It's just there and it's ready to go?
That is correct. So you as a developer can assume that the device already has Google Play services on it if it is Froyo and higher.
Okay.
And has Google Play installed.
Okay.
So what does this mean for you? This means that your APKs are much smaller when integrating with Google Plus. So practically, this means all of the Plus One button assets and images live inside Google Play services, and all of the functionality regarding Plus One-ing and signing the user in lives inside Google Play services, and you as a developer just need to worry about integrating the components into your application.
Awesome. So let's talk about Share. So here's an example of someone doing a share from an app. So the first thing that happens is that they click the button that will actually trigger the share. And then they get a form that's pre-populated with the text that will be shared. And then they can select the circles and the people that they want to share with. And then finally, after they click share, then the share will happen with the content that they populated the share interaction with. And there will also be an annotation from the app. So Chirag will tell you kind of how this works out in code.
So basically, the simplest way you can integrate the share button in your application is by adding a simple button. In the example Gus showed you earlier, we invoked the share through a list item. So you can integrate the share functionality anywhere in your application. So for this example, we're going to have a simple button incorporated from the Android SDK, and we're going to have simple text saying share on Google Plus. Next, we're going to find the simple share button from your layout and set its on-click handler to invoke the Google Plus share dialog. So let's deconstruct what's going on in this sample code. First, we build a share intent using the share compat library. This library makes it easier for you to build share intents and include rich media for your users to share on Google Plus. Here in this example, I pass text and a URL in the setText method. Next, I use the setType method to identify the type of content we're sharing as text/plain. Finally, we call the getIntent method to get the intent we've built with the share compat library. And finally, we call the setPackage method on the intent we've obtained, and we tell it to specify the Google Plus application. And this means that once the intent is launched, it'll directly open the Google Plus share dialog.
Now, Chirag, forgive me if I'm wrong, but share isn't exactly a new feature, right? Like, that's been around since the very beginning of G Plus, right?
Yeah, that is correct. So here we're launching an intent to open the Google Plus application. And the Google Plus application is responsible for launching the share dialog. And you, as a developer, can pre-fill the site type of text and URLs that are pre-populated in the share dialog.
Okay, so if a developer has already integrated the share experience into their app, now that we've added Google Play services, will anything be affected, or do they need to make any changes?
That is correct. So you won't need to make any changes. So if you want to add Google Play services, you can get new features such as the Plus One button and Sign In button.
Okay, good to know. Thank you.
Speaking of new features, here's the Mobile Plus One button. Here's an example of the Plus One button in the wild. And what you can see in this example is you can see that you and Julia Ferrioli have plus one this item inside of the Google Store. And so Chirag will tell you about how you can incorporate this functionality into your own apps.
So all you need to do is include the plus one button in your Android layout. Here, the attribute should look very similar to you because it inherits from a standard button. So you can control the layout width, height, but you can also declare the plus size attribute to declare the type of, to declare the appearance of the plus one button. And this size attribute is very similar to what you see on the web. We have the small, standard, medium, tall. Next, you'll initialize the plus one button in your onCreate handler. Here, you'll call the initialize method and pass in the URL that should be plus one.
So we have a button-o-matic, basically, that generates all the code for you for your web. Do we have anything similar for mobile?
So we don't have a o-matic, per se, for the plus one button, for the native plus one button on Android. But the appearance demonstrated through the plus one o-matic is very similar to the appearance of the plus one button on Android. For instance, the tall size will be very similar on native versus the web.
Okay, so
that's a great question.
Okay, so I don't have to go film any new videos, right?
Yeah.
We're good on that front.
Yeah.
Good to know.
Okay, so let's look at an implementation of the activity. So this is actually a full implementation. Chirag will actually break it down into the important parts for you.
So Gus showed you what your activity will look like once you integrate fully integrate the plus one button. But let's deconstruct what's going on over there. So in your onCreate handler, you will first initialize the plus client object and initialize the plus one button. And as you can see, when we're initializing the plus one button, we'll pass in the URL that should be plus one. Next, we'll integrate the plus client object in the lifecycle of your Android activity. So in your onStart handler, you'll call plusClient.connect. This will start to establish a connection between your third-party application and Google Play services. So your third-party application can start to connect to the resources in Google Play services and get the assets for the correct size of the plus one button you've integrated, but also control the functionality of the plus one button you've integrated in your application. And finally, in your onStop handler, you'll call plusClient.disconnect. And this will terminate the connection between your application and Google Play services. And this is a best practice because it'll reduce the number of resources incurred on the device when it's not being used.
Okay, so we just went through a lot of different steps. Is there somewhere online where people can find this information so they don't have to keep pausing the video and writing down all the code?
That's a great point. You don't need to take notes. Put down your pencils. You can visit developers.google.com/plus/mobile, and from there you'll find a beautiful getting started guide and a sample application that you can follow along with. And the sample application will look very similar to what we're covering here in the slides.
Thanks, Rob. All right, so the last thing we're going to talk about today is going to be sign-in with Google+. And so here's another example flow. A user clicks a sign-in button, and then they're presented with a list of their accounts on their Android device. After they select an account, they don't have to enter their mobile password again because it's saved and secure on their device. And then finally, after they're signed in, the application can open, and some information can be pulled from Google+. So Chirag will go into the integration steps for the sign-in button.
So integrating the sign-in button is very similar to integrating the plus one button, but you'll also include the get accounts permission in your Android manifest file. And this will allow your third-party application to obtain the list of accounts on the device. Next, you'll add the plus sign-in button to your layout. And again, this inherits from a standard button, so the look and feel of the interface should look very familiar.
So here's actually a full implementation of the plus sign-in button. Don't freak out. Chirag will actually break down the important pieces of this code so that it's easier for you to understand.
So the first important thing you'll do is sign the user in. And again, you will integrate the plus client object in the lifecycle of your Android activity. So when your onStart handler is invoked, you'll call plusClient.connect. But now in this case, two things can happen when plus client is invoked. Google Play services can go in and invoke your on-connection failed handler or your on-connection handler. Next, you'll implement your on-stop handler. And again, you'll call plusClient.disconnect to terminate the connection between your application and Google Play services. So as I mentioned before, either OnConnected is invoked from Google Play Services or OnConnection Failed is invoked from Google Play Services. OnConnected is analogous to the user being signed in. And when that method is invoked, you can update your user interface to reflect that the user is signed in. If the user is not signed in, your OnConnection Failed handler will be invoked. And with that, Google Play Services will pass in a connection result. You will hang on to this connection result, and you will resolve it when the user presses the sign in button. Now, we save connection result as a member variable in our activity. And when the user presses the sign in button, our onClick handler will be invoked, and we'll start resolving the connection result we saved in the member variable. And here we call mConnectionResult.startResolution for result. And we pass in a request code so we can get a handle on it once the response comes back. So now let's look at the onActivityResult handler. Whenever the activity comes back, we'll capture the request code and we'll see if it worked out okay. If the resolution worked out correctly, we'll call plus client again and complete the signing in of the user.
Now, okay, wait. So because this is all using Google Play Services, which lives inside of the Android SDK lives inside of Google Play Services, they can do all of this without including any of Google Play Services in their own ADK, right?
That is slightly true. So all of the complicated logic of Google Play Services and all of the image assets of the plus one button and sign in button will live on the device, but you'll include a lightweight jar to start establishing a connection between your application and Google Play Services. So you can obtain that jar from the Android SDK manager. And it's a very lightweight jar that simply connects to Google Play Services.
Okay, that makes sense then.
Great. So that's pretty much all we have to talk to you guys today about for updates for Google Plus for mobile developers. Mm-hmm. As always, remember you can get all the resources that we've talked about from the Google Plus developer documentation. And you can also ask questions on our Google Plus page. And we'll try to get to them in these office hours. And we can also try to get to them independently of this if you guys have questions.
Exactly, yeah. So I'm going to monitor for the next few minutes while we continue to talk. But if you think of anything later, if you're watching the YouTube video, we'll try to check back fairly regularly in the next few days to see if we can help you out again. In the meantime, so Lee, you've been listening with rapt attention for this whole thing. Do you have any comments or questions or just insights into what we've been talking about today?
So one question I have for you, Chirag, is if with Google Play Services being deployed to these Android devices, you said earlier that when I embed a share button into my application, it uses the share dialog from the Plus application. Do users still need to have a Plus application installed for me to be able to do that?
Yeah, that is correct. So the user will need to have the Google Plus Android application installed on their device for the share dialog to prompt up. And in Google Play Services, we offer a helper utility to check if the Google Plus application is installed. If it is installed, you can continue and create your share intent using the share compat library and launch the share dialog. But if the user does not have the Google Plus application installed, they can go out to the market and install it and then go back and resume sharing the content they want to share.
Great.
So that's a good question.
Okay. And Gus, I know that we first surfaced some of this documentation at Google I/O this year, and then we went into developer preview. So what does it mean for developers now that we're out of the developer preview phase? And like, what does that mean for these features?
Sorry, one second, I have to cough.
Not allowed.
But yeah, so the big difference between the functionality that we announced at I/O and today is that at I/O, the Google Play Services had not been out yet. And so this functionality was, we knew that it was going to be coming, and so we had that developer preview. But now that Google Play Services is out, mm-hmm. all of this is lit up on devices, and so the functionality is available.
Yeah.
So anybody, regardless of the preview group, is now able to develop with it and with the full access to the Google Play Services?
Yep. So now within your apps, that functionality like the plus one button is available, and up until this release last week, it was not possible to do this.
Okay, that's good to know. Lee, anything else while we wait?
One other question I did have actually is if you use sign in, if you use the sign in button, and you would like in your application to maybe at some critical point re-authenticate the user, is that possible?
So once the user signs in, they've identified themselves with the application, and the use and the application, it's effectively single sign-on. So the onConnected method will re-trigger if you like rotate the device or you put the activity to sleep for a certain amount of time. The activity will resume, and we'll call connect again, and onConnected will be invoked, and user is authenticated. Mm-hmm. So the only thing, if you swap users on the device, like if I sign out, if I remove my Gmail account on my device and add Gus on it, he would have to re-identify himself to the application. And then once he returns it back, I'd add my accounts back.
Cool. Thanks.
Thank you. Okay. So slightly off topic, we actually had a question posted on the GDL event on Google+. A while ago, and this person wants to ask about Hangouts, and I kind of they didn't know how to get their app started, so I directed them to our forum so that they could start looking into that. But one question that seems to be at the core of this that I think is worth at least discussing is they want to know about integrating Google+ Hangouts directly into their site. Now, maybe you can illustrate whether or not this is possible with the current API, or any insight you have into how this might be done. Because I don't, as far as I know, and I'm new, but I don't think that it's actually possible at this point in time. Is that correct?
That is correct. You can't integrate a Hangout within your application, but you can add the Hangouts button to invoke a Hangout into a new window.
Okay, so it still launches from Google+, but the button lives on your own site.
Yeah, you can use the simple Hangout button, and that'll create a new window. Or it'll open a new tab.
Okay, cool. So, Jeremy, I hope this helps you get started at least with where to look. And as always, please post in our forum. We don't really know how to help you with implementation details, but we would hopefully like to see other people helping you out and hope you find all the information you need. I'm not seeing any other comments appearing on our YouTube page. One person comments on our G+ event that they would like a suggestion for Google+, where you can join a streaming event from a Nexus tablet. So they're looking for mobile support for joining a streaming event.
Oh.
We'll work on that, Athar. In the meantime, we're going to post this on YouTube after we finish recording, so you can always go back and watch it after the fact. So anyone else have anything to say?
Not for me.
All right, well then, I have actually an announcement about Hangouts, which is that version 1.3 was just released. And this is really exciting because it has a normalizing feature, which is where you can mirror yourself. So let's say I go into a Hangout and my face comes up as I'm prepping and primping to make sure I look cute enough in my pajamas to talk to my sister. But I look weird because I'm backwards and I don't like that flopped image. Well, now I can mirror it. And it doesn't mirror for my sister, it just mirrors for myself so that I look normal to me as well as normal to her. And I think this is a really great feature for perspective, and I really like playing with it too. So I encourage you to play with 1.3 and start playing with that yourself. And one last check at our comments. I'm not seeing anything, so at the request of our visiting guest, I'm going to make a really bad pun and then we're going to say goodbye. So. How do you get holy water? Anyone?
How do you do it?
You boil the hell out of it.
Thanks, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.